I'm Matt Chapman. I'm standing in front of my Eagle 580 Airshow airplane, and you're watching Live Air Show TV.
You may not have heard of Matt Chapman, the commercial airline pilot who has flown tens of thousands of hours. Nor might you ever heard of Matt Chapman, the aerobatic competitor who has flown in many World Aerobatic Championships. But you have no doubt heard of Matt Chapman if you're an airshow fan. Matt has thrilled millions since turning in his competition wings in 1998 after finishing third in the world. And airshow fans are glad he did.
After that, I thought, man, I was just burned out. It's hugely, to do it on what I consider a professional level, the practice required, the equipment required, the commitment required, you give up so much of your life. And I thought after 17 years or however many it was competing and doing third in the world, it was time to do something else. I was broke, I was tired, I was burned out, and I figured if I went back to another world contest I could go up to, maybe, or down about 60 spots. So I thought get out while the getting out was good. And I've been doing air shows full time now since 1998.
Matt has been flying since 1979, and he can still vividly remember that first air show where the course of his life changed at age 19.
Never been to a show. I was as naive as anybody about what airplanes can do and what airplanes look like and things like that. So I watched this little single-seat pit special taxi in front of me, and I kind of chuckled out of going that little tiny biplane, 17-foot wingspan, can't weigh much more than 700 or 800 pounds, and it rocks by like that, and the guy's waving to the crowd. Then he goes to the end of the runway, turns the smoke on, and comes blasting up the runway, wheels 5 or 6 feet off the ground, and right in front of my dad and me, he flipped. There I am. I sound like an amateur. He rolled upside down, 10 feet off the ground, and I was floored, flabbergasted. I didn't know airplanes could really fly upside down. I thought just model airplanes. So I was like, oh my God. And I watched this guy fly. His name was David Perrin, a very famous British aviator. He inspired me. And I turned to my dad and I said, Dad, that's what I'm going to do. And lo and behold, you know, many years later, I did. I built myself an S1 Pit Special, and that was kind of the starting point.
Today, Matt flies a plane that sort of defies conventional description.
This is a French-built airplane, a 1992 Mudry Cap 231EX. It's one of six airplanes built. It's the only one in the United States. I've renamed it the Eagle 580 in honor of the Embry-Riddle athletic mascot. The airplane's a 360-horsepower airplane. It's a wooden fuselage and tail group and a carbon fiber wing. The EX on this airplane, it designates the wing having been built by the Extra Aircraft Company. So it's kind of a mix between a German aircraft and a French aircraft. Very capable. It's a fun airplane to fly.
He flies under the sponsorship of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. And he doesn't pull any punches when it comes to inspiring the next generation of aviators.
I just think it's about getting kids out to air shows, getting them involved in model aviation, you know, the AMA, Academy of Model Aeronautics. Get the kids building these models. Get them out to the field. Get them interested in doing something that is airplane related. It doesn't mean you have to love it, but it'll broaden their horizon if nothing else.
And Matt feels one of the best ways he can do that is to take to the skies on airshow weekends.
When I'm flying my airplane, any of us are flying our airplanes, the Blue Angels, Michael Goulian, Sean Tucker, Rob Holland, we're here to inspire people. We're here to entertain them, to show them that if you set your sights and your goals and you work hard, you can do anything you want to do. And at the end of the day, that's my job with Embry-Riddle, is to inspire the younger kids that are trying to make a decision about their careers, that Embry-Riddle's out there. And if they want a career, if they want to go to school and study aerospace, tell them Embry-Riddle is here and this is where you want to go.
And we've heard no better description of the thrill of being an airshow performer.
Getting ready for an airshow, you know, getting the airplane ready, getting strapped in, watching the other guys, seeing a big crowd, wanting to fly as well as I can fly. That's kind of the buildup, the adrenaline kind of part of it. And there is nothing better than getting in that airplane. And the first maneuver or two, you know if it's going to be a good flight or not. There's nothing better than second or third maneuver going, this is going to be a ride. You know, at the end of it, touching down, getting out of the airplane, getting the reaction from the crowd, meeting the kids, signing the autographs, high-fiving them. it's a great experience. It's a lot of fun. That's really gets my heart pumping. Airplanes get my heart pumping. Anything that flies, makes noise, burns fossil fuel, gets my heart pumping.
And hopefully someone in the crowd will catch that spark like he did. This year, Matt joins Rob Holland, Jack Knutson, and Bill Stein in a new four-ship aerobatic team called The Force. These guys have flown together in various combinations for years and will bring their remarkable talents together for a fantastic show in the 2013 airshow season. We will track their progress and let you know where they'll be during the season. For more information on Matt Chapman, The Force, and Embry-Riddle, go to the links section of our webpage. From the El Paso Amigo Air Show, I'm Jeff Lee, Live Air Show TV.